How is it, my brothers and sisters? It's your boy, The Island Boys, and I'm coming at you guys with my top 5 Mortal Kombat games of all time. Without further ado, let's get into this. Let's do this. I'm super excited to be doing my top 5. I've been saying this for such a long time that I've been gonna do a top 5 Mortal Kombat games of all time video, and I never got into it. But recently, I made a tier list of all Mortal Kombat games ever made, and I decided, hey, first off, I'll start with my top 5, and then I'll go into top 10, and then I'll do all Mortal Kombat games of all time, and I'll just keep doing more videos like these, and I hope you guys enjoy them. So, let's get into this. At number 5, we're gonna go with Mortal Kombat 11. So, the most recent installment of the Mortal Kombat franchise, I believe Mortal Kombat 11 comes in at number 5 for a couple of reasons. I don't think it's in the top 3, and I wouldn't say it's number 6 or anywhere in the top 10. I think number 5 is a perfect place to put it. One, because as putting everything as a whole, you have to take into consideration graphics, customization, characters, story, crypt, all the other special features that come with the game, and all that kind of stuff. And if you guys haven't seen my comparison video of MK11 and MKX, I would highly suggest watching that video. Yes, and find it in probably the top viewed videos. But yeah, I do a comparison between MKX and MK11, and I hope you guys enjoy that. So if you guys want a more detailed video on my comparison between MK11 and MKX, I would highly suggest you guys watch that. So for MK11, it's such a great game. The graphics are great. You have customization now where you can customize all your characters and have all these different gears and movesets. Like I said, the graphics are amazing. The story was okay. They had the Aftermath DLC, which was awesome. However, there are some flaws with this game that I believe it puts it at number 5. That being the roster. I think the roster could use a lot of work. There aren't that many characters that I see that I'm like, you know what, I want to go play that character. And I always, like when I was playing MKX and MK9, there were many characters that I wanted to play. MK11, it's not like that. It doesn't have the same vibe for some reason. I think it might just be how some characters might be a little bit overpowered and some characters might be just not powered at all, not powerful whatsoever. I also think it has to deal with just maybe the new characters that were introduced, such as Collector, Geras, Cetrion, all those kind of characters, and DLC characters. I believe that the DLC characters from MKX were far superior than the DLC characters that we have so far in MK11. Of course, there's going to be DLC characters later on, but I have no idea who they could be. It could be Rain, it could be, I heard Rambo was going to be in it. Who knows who's going to be in this MK11 DLC. But for now, it seems that MKX has a far greater roster and DLC than MK11. Also, MK11 introduced the new breakaway system and roll, and I also think that causes a bit of problems. I like the MK9 and MKX breakaway, where it set everyone back to neutral instead of having to fall down like MK11 is, or roll. And if you fall down, you can get, there's armor breaks, armor breakaways, or armor punishes, where if you break away, all characters can now just have an armor move and basically armor through that breakaway. And not all those armor breaks are even powerful. Like Sonya Blades is pretty terrible. You could just do a down 2 instead of her forward 3. And that's forward 3 is her armor move. And down 2 is an uppercut. And the down 2 does more damage than the breakaway move. Or break armor breakaway move. So it's just a lot of flaws with that in itself. And even if you do a breakaway and someone can be doing a combo and mid combo, let's say for instance, Aaron Black, what does he have? The back 2, or is it back 2? His little overhead, is it mid string? Yeah, his back 2 where he like hits the gun over someone's head. If he's doing that combo and you break away or whatever and it whiffs, and then you can just punish him, and you shouldn't be punished for doing a combo. It should set everyone back to neutral. So that's why I feel like there are some problems with MK11 that make it deserve it to be at number 5. Coming in at number 4, we're gonna have Mortal Kombat X. Now, Mortal Kombat X, oh my goodness, where do I begin? So many great things that happened in this game. We had the DLC characters, the phenomenal DLC characters. They had Alien, Predator, Leatherface, Tremor, Tribor, Goro. The list could go on. Such phenomenal DLC characters. The roster was amazing, introducing the new generation of characters and fighters such as Cassie Cage, Jackie Briggs, Kung Jin, Takeda, all those amazing characters. What a phenomenal roster. Fast gameplay, really fast gameplay, super brutal. I loved it. It was amazing. Such a great game, and I would honestly put it in as my number 2 or even number 3, but I have to give credit where credit is due. And that is at number 3, Mortal Kombat 2. With Mortal Kombat 2, the hype was unreal when this game came out. After Mortal Kombat came released and everyone was super hyped about the game, Mortal Kombat 2 came out and just blew Mortal Kombat out the ballparks. It had better sound quality, it introduced a lot of things such as babalities, friendships, better sound quality, better graphics, maps. You can do finishers on maps such as uppercutting your opponent up to the ceiling, uppercutting your opponent to the ground as a finisher. So many great things. It introduced Shang Tsung when he was younger. It introduced Kentaro. Such a phenomenal game. Great game. Loved it. Such a classic. And coming in at number 2 is Mortal Kombat Trilogy. Now, after the release of Mortal Kombat 3 and Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, Mortal Kombat Trilogy came out and just blew those two straight out the ballpark. You have to say, without a doubt, that Mortal Kombat Trilogy has the greatest roster of all time. You could even play as Shao Kahn, Goro, Kentaro, all those amazing bosses. You can play them all in MK Trilogy. It has the best roster all time. Quote me on it, best roster all time. The sound to select your characters, the music in the background, the maps, the fast pace of the game. It literally just blew Mortal Kombat 1 and Mortal Kombat 2 out the ballpark. It blew everyone's mind with brutalities, fatalities, babalities, friendships. I believe you could even do mercies in this game. Customizing Shang Tsung's morphs. You can do so much with this game. That was the first Mortal Kombat game that I ever played, actually. Might be a little bit biased, but you have to give credit where credit is due. Mortal Kombat Trilogy just blew everyone's expectations. It said goodbye Mortal Kombat 3, goodbye Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, hello Mortal Kombat Trilogy. Such a great game, loved it. Also with MK Trilogy, it also had the 2v2s and it had the 8-player combat, which was also in Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, but it just carried over to MK Trilogy. So on top of having the great roster, the fast gameplay, the juggling combos, the great maps, the babalities, the friendships, the mercies, all that kind of stuff, you were able to do 2v2s and 8-player combat. Like, what? This was like the Armageddon of the older generation people. Like, whoever grew up in the Armageddon generation, just imagine Trilogy is the Armageddon of our generation. So that's how basically we sum it up. Before we get into our number one spot, I want to say thank you guys all so much for watching this video and even coming to the end of this video and watching it fully through. And if you haven't yet, please like this video, comment below your top 5 favorite Mortal Kombat games of all time. Leave a like, leave a comment, leave a subscribe, share the video, follow the Instagram channel at The Island Boys. And without further ado, let's get on to our number one pick. Coming in at number one is Mortal Kombat 9. And I'm sure everyone figured this one out. Mortal Kombat 9 is basically the Tekken 3 of Tekken. It is so amazing, such a great roster. It's everything a Mortal Kombat player ever wanted. Introducing x-rays, introducing new ways to do juggle combos, bringing back classic maps, bringing back classic characters. It was everything that a Mortal Kombat player ever wanted. The DLC characters were awesome, although very limited. I know PlayStation had exclusive with Kratos, and we had DLC such as Freddy Krueger, Rain, such a great roster. Would I say it's better than MK Trilogy? Ooh, I probably wouldn't say that. I think MK Trilogy holds the top bar for the best roster of all time. MK9's story was awesome, bringing in from Mortal Kombat 1 to Mortal Kombat 3, tying them all together while also creating a new story. Such a great game. A lot of memories were made by that game. It had tag team. It had all these other great game modes you could play. Such a memorable game. MK9 definitely deserves the number one spot. Thank you guys all so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and listening to my top 5 Mortal Kombat games of all time. Let me know if you guys agree or disagree, what you guys would move around, and let me know your guys' top 5 games of all time. Don't forget, like, comment, subscribe, share the video, follow the Instagram channel at The Island Boys, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Shoot.